Hi, this is Peter Corrigan. Thought I'd give a quick video while I'm stuck in a traffic jam here. This is a quick video to start the Whatever It Takes series. I'm just driving towards my work, a job which I got in the pandemic, the lockdown, a small job to bring in the capital and money for my next business venture. And I'm just on the way to this job right now, live, just in a traffic jam, so I'm okay to film. I'm not driving fast, just going slow. So yeah, you know, whatever it takes to bring in money and capital for your next business venture. We need that capital to get started with a project. And this is what I'm doing. I will show you what I'm going to do to bring in the money. Again, it's not about the job I'm about to do. It's about the entrepreneur mindset and entrepreneur spirit. Whatever it takes. So I'm just going towards my work in a traffic jam. See you in the next video. Take care. Hi, this is Peter Corrigan. Talked about entrepreneur, finance, money and wealth. Let me just take this mask off. Hi there. In the last video, I was talking about getting a job or whatever it takes to raise capital and finance for your next business venture. Well, this is what I'm doing to raise the capital. Whatever it takes, I've got a job working for someone else, and this is what it takes for me. This is my journey of an entrepreneur, and this is what I'm doing. I'm not saying do this, do your own, but what I'm saying is whatever it takes to get that finance, that capital to start your business, to start that business venture, are you willing to do whatever it takes as long as it's legal and not hurting anybody? Let me just show you what I'm doing to raise the capital for my next business venture. Let's have a look at this. Come on, I'll show you. This is real and this is live. I'm actually doing it now. Okay, as you can see, I got myself a job as a cleaner, as a toilet cleaner, to raise that capital. It's hard for me to clean while I'm filming at the same time. But this is what I'm doing to raise the money for my next business venture. And it's about being determined. It's about being focused. And I'm willing to do this job to get that capital while my other business ventures are on hold at the moment, with the pandemic and the lockdown. So this is bringing that extra income and that income so I can put it away for my next business venture. What are you prepared to do? What are you prepared to do for whatever it takes, again, as long as it's legal and it's not hurting anybody, to raise that capital? Because we do need money for our startups. We do need money to start up a business or a business venture. So I just thought I'd show you what I do. And these toilets are spotless because I'm an entrepreneur and I make sure that they're spotless. So this is my journey of being an entrepreneur. I hope you're getting something out of this, and I hope to see you in the next videos. Take care of yourself. Hi, this is Peter Corrigan talking about entrepreneur business, finance and money. This is in the series of the entrepreneur journey and whatever it takes. Whatever it takes to get that capital. This is my second job, which I took during the pandemic and the lockdown to raise that capital for my next business venture. It's an office cleaner. It's a part-time office cleaning job. Second job, like I do toilet cleaning as well. So this is a part-time. You could get part-time jobs, temporary jobs, you know, just to earn that extra capital for that business venture of yours. So this is what I'm doing, a second job, as I said. But it's not about the job, it's about the dedication and the passion to want to build a business and raise finance and capital for your next business venture. It's how determined you are. And as I said before, this money is going to go into that venture, which I'm about to do. So I'm prepared to clean toilets and be an office cleaner. What are you prepared to do? Are you prepared to take extra jobs or do some extra work to raise the capital for your next business venture? So this is a little bit of a video just to show you my journey of being an entrepreneur and what it takes to raise that capital for your next business. I'll see you later in the next video. I've got some work to do. I've got to clean this office now. See you in the next video. Take care. Hi, this is Peter Corrigan, entrepreneur, talking about business, finance and money. As you just seen in the last video on whatever it takes to raise capital and finance for your next business venture. I've just finished work, a long day at work. I'm tired, I'm in my car, ready to go home. I've something to eat and take the dog for a walk. But it's not about the job. This isn't what this video's about. I'm not saying become a cleaner or a toilet cleaner like me. No. It's about whatever you're prepared to do for your next business venture. What are you prepared to do to get that finance so you can set up that business and your business venture? So it's about that. So you find your own way, find your own way of getting that finance and starting that business. And it's my journey of being an entrepreneur. But you have got to be dedicated. You've really got to want it. I'm hungry for it and I want it and I'm dedicated. And as you can see, whatever it takes me to produce that income, I will do. As long as it's legal and I'm not hurting anybody, as I said. So it is about that. And I'm looking forward to putting this money into my business venture in the future, which I will show you. I am going to show you live what the finance, what I'm building up, working for someone else in a job, and I'll show you where I will put that money into my next business venture. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you're enjoying this journey with me as an entrepreneur, and take care of each other. Hi, this is Peter Corrigan talking about entrepreneur, finance, business and money. just where I am in my entrepreneur journey. I've just had an health scare where I found a lump in the lower part of my body. Can be quite worrying when you have health scares in your entrepreneur journey. To be honest with you, it's very inconvenient that I seem to have an health scare, and do you know what? I ain't got really time for it, and I ain't got time to bleed. I call it, I ain't got time to bleed. I've just had an ultra scan, just come out of the ultra scan, and good news, the lump is not serious. It's just a fatty tissue. But when I first found it, it were quite worrying. But I tried to forget about it, and I carried on with all the projects and things I had to do for my business venture. As I said, I were annoyed about finding the lump, to be honest with you, because I felt that it was sort of stopping me, and I'd have to sort of put things back. So it were quite annoying, really. But we've got to really look after, as an entrepreneur, we've got to look after our health. We've got to keep fit and go on a diet, which I'm putting myself on a diet now. It's no good having a business and try to reach to the heights of success if our health is not fully healthy. Because you are rich when you've got your full health as well. So, a bit of an health scare during my journey. The lump's fine, it's just a fatty tissue. And as I says, to be honest with you, I haven't got time to bleed. So I'm happy that everything is fine. And it's all green light again. And go, go, go to get this business venture going. See you in the next video. Don't forget, take care of each other. Bye-bye. Hi, this is Peter Corrigan. Talking about entrepreneur, finance, business and money. Short video on showing you where I stand with my business venture and my business journey at the present time. Well, in about, I would say, 20 minutes, I've got to, and I'm going towards the jobs of a toilet cleaner and office cleaner, which I showed you in the last videos, to earn the income and to supply me some capital to do the business venture. As you can see, it is absolutely scorching, round about 24 to 30, absolutely sat here in the garden, and I'm sweating just sat here. So the job I'm going to do, I'm not complaining, because I choose to do it, it is absolutely unbearable. We've got to wear an hairnet, we've got to still wear our mask and earplugs as I'm doing physical work, cleaning toilets, which is hard work, and I'm drenched from head to toe, t-shirt wet through. I'm not complaining, I'm just reporting what it's taking me to do this business venture. At the moment, everything is stacked against me doing this business venture. The business venture which I'm about to do is not a new idea. It's not something I invented. It was just an opportunity I saw, and it's an idea, and I reacted on it. Can I pull it off? Is what the gurus say when you see an opportunity, act fast. Is it true, or is it a load of BS? All the books and all the study videos, listening to gurus, reading books about how to be an entrepreneur and how to be successful. Is it true, or is it a load of BS? I will be showing you exactly what the business venture is. Everything's against it at the moment, especially COVID-19 and the lockdown. That's totally against it.
If they lock us down again in the winter months, then that will definitely stop this idea, this business venture I'm about to do. It will totally stop it. So that's against me. The heat is against me because I do feel like just calling it a day with the work I'm about to do, because it's so unbearable. I could easily pack it all in, delete this journey and forget it completely. But no, I want to do this journey, see if I can pull it off. It's a challenge to me. I'm passionate about it. And I wanted to see if a toilet cleaner or a bog cleaner or whatever you call it, who's on minimum wage, not much money, can I bring an idea and create a business venture? Can we do it? Can we become an entrepreneur and try to better ourselves or not? Or is this just for people, other people, and not people like us? But I think I can, and I'm confident I can. It's like an experiment. I'm putting myself in an experiment in this journey, possibly for you guys. And I will report to you whether my business venture is successful or not. I will film it live. I'm not saying what it is at the moment, because I want to show you guys what it is. But when you see it, you'll know that everything was stacked against me, because the idea at the moment, everybody has shut it down. Everybody with the claws down and the lockdown. But I saw an opportunity, and they say, and the gurus say, if you see an opportunity, act very quickly. And I have done. Is that true, or is that a load of BS? That's what we've got to find out on this business and business venture. Stay with this. Keep watching my videos and see if an ordinary guy who's just working class, doing a menial task job as a toilet cleaner, getting minimum wage, can I pull it off and do a business venture and start to be successful? Some people will think that the business venture is not success, but we all have different successes. To me, it's a challenge. So if I do pull it off, it's a massive success to me. And I'm just proving to myself that I can do it. And you guys will be able to do it as well. Because if I can do it and I can pull it off, so can you guys definitely pull it off. So stay with this venture, and hope to see you in the next videos. And remember, take care of each other. I'm just going now to this job. Oh my God, not looking forward to it. Take care of each other. Bye-bye. Hi, this is Peter Corrigan talking about entrepreneur, finance, business and money. Where am I at the moment with my business venture? Well, it's going really, really well. The target for this business venture is the 10th of December. Keep your eye open for that day. I will be filming it live, the 10th of December. In this video, I will be giving a few clues out on what the business venture is. I'll be showing you if you so want to. In fact, I'll show you now. My marketing material and the market materials are going really, really well. Just got some new leaflets through, looking really smart and looking really good. There you go. There's a clue on what business venture I will be doing on the 10th of December. As I said in the last videos, don't ever neglect your marketing side. Entrepreneurs and beginner entrepreneurs and young entrepreneurs can neglect this side of the business. But you know what? You're in the business of marketing. You are a marketer and you are a salesman. Whether you like it or not, that is your business. If you don't have that, you don't have a business. So we can't neglect it. I'm marketing all the time, 24/7, talking to people, putting leaflets through letterboxes, handing out leaflets. Leaflets are great to talk about your business. It gives you a chance to interact with the public while you're giving out leaflets and talking to them and advertising your business. Every person I talk to, if I find an opportunity to talk about my business and give business cards out and leaflets and show them videos, I do. And I do that all the time because I'm a promoter and that's my business. That's another clue. So things are going really, really well. As I said before, I do the old way with the new way. I've got a new website coming up in a few weeks' time, just before 10th of December, the target. So that will be nicely timed well for the new website to go up. I'll give you the address later on in the future so you can take a look at that website and see my website as well. I'll be delivering these leaflets myself, going from door to door, putting them through letterboxes. I do the hard work, I do the footwork as well. So both marketing the old way and marketing on the internet as well. So things are really, really going good. A couple of clues there in this video on what business venture I'm doing. Someone out there will probably already guess. They'll slow that video down, have a look at that poster and read it and know exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to film it live as well. I've been promoting this for over 2 years now and getting this business venture ready. I started this business venture before the COVID-19, but I had to shut it down, obviously, lockdown. And lockdown stopped me from launching my business venture, but I didn't worry about it. I stuck at it. I don't give up. It's been there at the back of my mind, and I've been wanting to do this business venture for many, many years. So stay with this. 10th of December, I will be videoing it live and showing you guys what I'm doing. And you know what? If you ever see me in the future and you come to my business venture and you see me, just come up to me and say, I've been following your entrepreneur journey on YouTube and I will talk to you about it. And you know what? I will give you a personal gift if you come up to me personally. You're quite welcome to just say, I've been following you on the entrepreneur journey on YouTube. Love to see you at my business venture. Remember, keep marketing, keep selling, and don't give up. This is Peter Codigan talking about entrepreneur, finance, business and money. And take care of each other. Bye-bye. Hi, this is Peter Codigan talking about entrepreneur, finance, business and money. Really excited this morning. Had some promotional material delivered and really excited. Had me tickets printed, outsourced this, so people were doing it, and they're looking really good, don't you think? They look really good, the tickets there. So don't neglect your promotional materials, don't neglect your marketing side. I'm using the old way as well as doing the internet. I am getting some posters done, some leaflets done. I will be putting some leaflets through the letterbox and putting posters up and putting leaflets around on notice boards, billboards. So the old way still works. I will be doing the internet marketing, but I'm doing both. So don't neglect the old way as well. Don't think the old way isn't working, because it does. And don't neglect your marketing side. Don't neglect your spending money on your material, on your marketing material, because it's really important. So my business venture is going well. The promotional side and the marketing side, really excited about these tickets just arrived today. And I think they're looking really good there, you know. So really excited about that. And see you in my next videos on the entrepreneur journey. Is this business venture going to take off or not? I feel it will. I'm confident. I'm really excited about it now. It's getting closer and closer, each step at a time, building it up. So see you next video on entrepreneur journey, and take care of each other. Bye bye. Hi, this is Peter Corrigan talking about entrepreneur, finance, business and money.
I'm just about to go around the venue which I've just booked for this show, for my business venture at this venue here. I'm just about to go around and deliver leaflets to the locals around to drum up people to come to the event. So I'm doing the marketing both ways, on the internet and the old way, delivering leaflets and putting posters around on notice boards and delivering leaflets through letterboxes. But I'm also doing the internet as well. I do the modern way with the old way. So as I said in all the videos, don't neglect the old way of delivering leaflets. Here's one of my posters, just there, you can see. That's one of my posters on one of their glass there. So I'm putting posters up and leaflets all around. And this is what I'm doing on this entrepreneur journey, doing the footwork and really putting the leaflets through the letterbox there. So we've got to keep marketing all the time. I keep emphasizing this on the videos. It's so important to market. We can't neglect this side. We can't neglect the marketing side of the business and your new business venture. We've got to market all the time in sales, as you can see on the a notice board there, the notice board of where I'm doing the venue at this fantastic venue. So just about to deliver some leaflets through letterboxes. See you in a moment and take care of each other. Bye. I just going round delivering the leaflets door to door. Just putting the leaflets through the letterboxes there, marketing and doing the footwork, which is good. Delivering leaflets in the community. So if you've got leaflets, you know, put them through letterboxes, put them on notice boards, in shops, hairdressers is good, salons, and door to door. Done for today. It's starting to rain, so I think I've delivered enough leaflets around today. Getting a bit wet there. So leaflet delivering round letterboxes, putting posters round on notice boards and billboards. The old way is very important and very useful. Why am I putting leaflets round doors, someone might ask. The question might ask, why aren't I targeting my audience and knowing what they're wanting? That's a good question, and I will answer that later on. But why am I doing the old way, the leaflets? Like I've put a leaflet through this letterbox. How do I know these people are wanting to come to my event? Well, I don't. It's a numbers game. I'm putting as many leaflets round as much as possible, and a numbers game. Someone out of the leaflets, law of averages, will possibly be interested and come and buy the tickets. But the beautiful thing about it, it's not about really getting the people to buy the tickets as well
On the leaflet, it's got my company's name and my logo. So I'm branding myself as well. Even though these people might not want to come to my event, they will look at the leaflets and they will notice the name, Corrigan's Live Shows. They'll notice, and that'll go into the subconscious mind. So in the future, when they hear Corrigan's Live Shows, that will pop up in front of the conscious mind, and they'll say, I've heard of that company before. So I'm branding as well. So that's the secret for leaflets, and putting your name and your company on leaflets and your promotional materials. You're not just wanting the sales and the tickets, we are also secretly and subliminally branding our company. So I'm not bothered if these people buy a ticket or not. I know that my name's getting round and people are getting to know Corrigan's Live Shows, and that's what I'm doing with me promotional material. So I've had enough now, done enough leaflets, going home, going to have a coffee, and I'll see you in the next videos, and take care of each other. Bye bye. Hi, this is Peter Corrigan talking about entrepreneur, finance, business and money. Hi, welcome to my business venture. This is what I'm doing tonight. This is what I said I was going to film it live for you guys and stream live for you. I'm here live at the show. I've put on an Adele show, tribute band, and it's going absolutely fantastic. A sellout. All the seats have been taken. They're really enjoying the sell. And this is my business venture, which I've put on, organised, promoted. And I'm really, really pleased about it. It's going really, really well. The staff's really great here. The venue's absolutely fantastic. I love the venue. And everyone's been really, really good. So let me get back to the show. I will be filming it and taking some photographs for you guys. So enjoy. Bye-bye. I To put on the show which I'm about to put on and the business. Take care. Taking some photographs for you guys. So enjoy. Bye bye. Hi, this is Peter Corrigan, talking about entrepreneur, business, finance and money. Well, what a journey this has been, my entrepreneur journey. From a cleaner to a creator of a business venture. I did it. Successful. The event went off absolutely amazing. I was pleased the way the event went. Financially, I did quite well. Paid for all my overheads and got some profit, which is business, what we want. But it's not about that. The event was about the people enjoying themselves. And was it worth it? Of course it was. When I saw the people all dancing and enjoying themselves, the music to Natalie Black, tribute to Adele, all the hard work, what I put through as a cleaner and an office cleaner, working long hours, were completely worth it. From a cleaner to an entrepreneur. The journey doesn't stop here. I will be carrying on the journey. Now I've done it once and I've put an event on once, I'm going to do what we call rinse and repeat. All I need to do now is to repeat it. I've got about 6 shows lined up for next year as well. Hopefully we don't get locked down in the middle of the year. But if we don't, I will be putting them shows on as well. I will be taking this business as far as I can to the limit. I will be pushing it and promoting shows, different shows and different venues and all around the UK. This is the start of my journey, my business adventure journey, an entrepreneur. If I can do it, you can do it. I worked hard as a cleaner. That money supplemented the money to put on the event. I saved up with the finance because we need income, like I said in the other videos, to promote the event and to put money into your business venture. So you do need some money. So if you are in a day job, do not give up your day job and just pack it up and start a business venture. No, keep that job going and build your business venture alongside your regular job. Use some of that money to promote your business venture, and then when it takes off, then obviously you'll be able to do the business venture full time. So that's what I've done. It's been a long journey and it's not finished here. I'm passionate about it and determined about it and constantly thinking about it and visualizing it, and I was determined to pull this venture off. I had confidence. I was visualizing it all the time. I had an inside feeling of I knew I could do it. Never doubted myself. So positive and so passionate about putting on this event. Never done it before. Learning along the way. Making mistakes. Oh, so many mistakes I've made along the journey. But it was total worth it, especially when I saw everyone dancing, as you can see on the videos, and enjoying themselves. As I said, if I can do it from a cleaner, getting minimum wage, building a business venture and becoming an entrepreneur, you guys can as well. So don't give up. Keep going. Keep the passion and build your business venture. This is Peter Corrigan on the road to be successful, which I am. I'm classing that as success. Even just one event, that is being successful. This is Peter Corrigan on the entrepreneur journey. Take care of each other. Let me just shout out like Rocky. Adrian! I did it! Take care of each other.
Bye-bye. This is right.